So tying this together with our chapter four material, right, where we talked about labor markets and financial markets. So first of all, we're going to talk about the wage elasticity of labor supply. So wage elasticity of labor supply is telling us the percentage change in the quantity of labor that is actually supplied. So we're going to say percentage change in the supply for labor divided by the percentage change in the wage. And so this is the situation where, you know, let's say that the price, the equilibrium wage, has fallen significantly. A bunch of people might decide to not work in the workforce as a result. They might go to college, they might just drop out of the labor force and, you know, live off government benefits or their savings or whatever the case may be, right? And conversely, if the equilibrium wage is increasing significantly, this is going to incentivize people into the labor force. Maybe, you know, if you knew that you could get a job working on an oil field for $130,000, you wouldn't be in school right now, right? So when the wage increases, it incentivizes people to jump out of other types of activities and into the labor market. So the other side of the incentivize more people to join the labor market is the wage elasticity of labor demand. The wage elasticity of labor demand is our percentage change in the demand for laborers by employers by this percentage change in the wage, right? And so we know that this is going to be a negative number because of our law of demand. We know that as wages increase, firms are going to demand less of them. They're going to try everything they can to, you know, replace those workers with robots or replace those workers with customers doing the work themselves, like self-checkout machines or apps where you can purchase food without having to order through somebody, right? All right, our last bit before we get to our Kahoot, and then we're done for the day. We'll pick up with chapter six in class on Thursday. The last bit that we've got.